Cliffhangers is one of the most popular games in Price is Right history. Easily a favorite among viewers, with many considering it to be the best game on the show. The premise is simple. The mountain climber moves slowly up the scale one step per dollar missed, but don't exceed 25 steps or he'll fall right off the cliff. I don't know how I can even limit this list to only 5 facts, but I'll try to come up with some points that we can all say are pretty cool and fun to chat about. Clearly there's going to be some points that people will say, "I forgot," but that's okay because we all have our opinions on what belongs and what doesn't. We all find different elements interesting. So here we go with one of the most enjoyable landmark games of The Price is Right. Here are 5 fun facts about Cliffhangers. Number 5. The Merch Line. Cliffhangers is so popular that it's fairly easy to grab some sweet mountain climber swag. I'm not sure if I'm bold enough to wear a Cliffhanger shirt in public unless I was going to a taping, of course. Either way, there are some cool designs available. Now, if they only made some sweet Professor Price merch, I would totally hit that up for the hipster factor. On second thought, that might be a real mistake. Number 4. The Yodeling. Unlike the previous game of Hurdles, where the William Tell Overture music cut was one of the most popular songs in television and film, this one was a little more of a deep dive. The yodeling music is from a 1957 album titled Swiss Mountain Music. The song is called On the Franche Mountains by Jura Orchestra. The part we are all familiar with starts about 41 seconds in. Having said that, I am pretty sure I've heard the rest of the song used in other aspects of media. Comment if you believe you've heard it before as well. Number 3. The $350 bid. There have been some crazy bids over the years, but this one might have had the best reaction. In 1992, a contestant named Clint was asked to bid on a watch. Clearly unaware that he was not bidding on a Rolex or anything of that sort, he decided on a rather unrealistic $350 bid. Bob, knowing that this was not going to end well for the mountain climber, took a seat at the foot of the cliff and asked Clint to join him. And together, the two of them sat and watched the mountain climber begin a dangerous journey that, not unlike the ending of Thelma and Louise, was destined to be tragic, heroic, and legendary, all at the same time. Number 2. Halloween and costume changes. While the show has had a long history of celebrating days like April Fool's Day, only since the Drew era has the show celebrated Halloween. And in 2009, Drew showed up dressed like he was ready to climb the mountain himself. While Halloween shows could easily become insufferable, this show seems to knock it out of the park every year. And while we're on the topic of costume changes, it is also noted that in recent years, the mountain climber has been known to wear a costume or two, including Santa Claus during Christmas, Cupid during Valentine's Day, and was even joined by his adorable sister on Siblings Day. Themed events like these are what makes various episodes special, and while I don't agree with every change made, notice I did not refer to the mountain climber as Yodely Guy, I think it is perfectly fine to mix up the look of the game for the sake of special days. And while some people may not ever want the show to change, the world is constantly evolving, and that is important to remember. Before I continue, I just want to say that I am well aware of the Fritz controversy from the nighttime version. It is not something that adds to the enjoyment of this game or this channel, so it is not a topic for this list. We're keeping this series fun. And the number one fun fact about Cliffhangers: the game has appeared on multiple other TV shows. Not even including guest appearances on other CBS shows, including Let's Make a Deal and The Late Show, Cliffhangers has appeared as itself or in some various parody formats on other shows outside of the network, including but not limited to Family Guy, Phineas and Ferb, and Big Mouth, just to name a few. What more is there to say? It doesn't matter if you're a casual fan or know every episode, people generally love Cliffhangers, and they love that growing sense of anxiety for every step the mountain climber takes to the top. May Cliffhangers live on for many years to come.